start to your Monday. Today I want to talk to you about something that I've actually been struggling with for, I don't know, about a month and a half or so. Last month in January, I went to my second live event of training called First Steps to Success. This training was filled with everything that you could possibly imagine for everyday life. Finances, debt, raising children, building a business, succeeding in a job that you already have. You know, everything that you could possibly imagine that you need in life. And the week before I went, I got a book called Spirit-Driven Success. And in the first three chapters, it pulled me completely in. I was hooked from head to toe. Don't mind the noise in the background. That's my 2.5-year-old Daisy playing. But in the first couple chapters, it talked about your spiritual gifts, the gifts that God gives you from day one. He has a plan for each and every one of us, and some of us don't understand what those plans are right away, and others figure it out like snap. You've done it. You know exactly what you were meant to do. You know where you're going. Some of us, if you're like me, it took me 27 years to figure it out. I had no idea that God gave you gifts, that God has a plan. I knew that He had a plan, but there's an actual specific plan for each and every one of us in this world. And so after reading that chapter of Spiritual Gifts, I was like, okay, I got this. I know exactly what I was meant to do. I can do this, you know. Then I went to First Steps to Success, and again, I thought, okay, I got this. I know what my gifts are. I can make this work for my family and I. Then a couple weeks ago, I'm struggling. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. Like, God, I know He has a plan for me, and I'm praying, and I'm in tears, and I'm praying, and I'm in tears, you know, for the last 2 or 3 weeks. And it's just, I don't know. There's no way for me to describe it to you. You know what I'm trying to say when you're struggling and you just don't understand what to do, where to go, and how to do it. You have all these excuses. You have all these things going on in your head. And then Sunday, yesterday, we went to church and our pastor was talking about, you guessed it, spiritual gifts. And it finally hit me as to what God wants me to do and where I need to be. And I hope that this enlightens you in your growth with God and with your life. I know it's not easy to go on about life, especially when you are in the middle of a huge struggle. You know, leaving an ex or broke and don't know how to pay bills. I mean, there's so many situations out there. I have been in countless myself with my family. And I have been in a place where I've denied God more than once. You know, I'm just like, how could there really be this one person, this one thing in this world that can really take hold and do things and bless you and, you know, yada, yada, yada. When I was in college, I went to a spiritual thing and it was awesome. I felt the power of God. And then after I left that, I went back into my old ways and went right into the devil's hand. So yesterday when the pastor was talking about spiritual gifts, I was like, oh my gosh, I cannot believe I have, you know, skipped over this. I can't believe it hasn't dawned on me until now. So I just wanted to share with you just a little bit about what my gift is. And I hope that it opens up something in you and for you to go out and find your gift. If you already know what your gift is, comment it below. I would love to, you know, hear what gift you think you have been blessed with. There's a reason why you're good at things. There's a reason why you are horrible at other things. The reason why you're good at these things over here is because that circles around what God blessed you with. And the reason why you're not so good at this stuff over here is it might not pertain to your gift that you've been blessed with. So sometimes you just gotta take in what you've truly been blessed with and where you're going in life. And I know it's hard. I know it's hard to be like, okay, God blessed me with this. I can do this. I can go. And then the next day happens and all hell breaks loose. It's hard. It really is. But let me tell you a little bit about me, my gift. And then I want you to share with me what your gift is. Because we are all a gift of the body of Christ. And without my gift, others can't operate their gift. And without their gift, I can't operate my gift. So we all have to work as one, in a circle, in a piece. And yes, I'm one of those people, why can't everybody just get along? But here's what I believe my gift is. And I'm going to try to live up to it as best as I can. Because when I live up to my gift, I feel at peace with myself. I don't feel as stressed as I usually am. So here's my gift. I started a lifestyle change a little over 2 years ago now. Well, it's about 2 years. And ever since then, I randomly get messages from people saying, you've really inspired me to lose 57 pounds. You've really inspired me to change my healthy eating. I was this close to diabetes, and now because of your posts and your commitment to what you're doing, I've been following you, and now I'm further away from the diabetes spectrum. So thank you. I get messages like this all the time. And I'm really trying to hold back the tears because you guys, you're amazing. These messages really show me that I'm doing what God blessed me to do. I have struggled with my entire life to figure out what I was put here for. I wasn't put here just to be a mother. There's no way. That is such a huge task. Like, there's got to be something that's specifically what I'm meant to be. Being a mother is the biggest thing that I've been blessed to be. And the biggest and hardest and worst and most amazing and all these emotions all into one job. But I knew that there was something, just one small thing, that I was meant to do. There are so many mothers in this world. Each one is different in their own way. Some mothers are the most creative and make their children dresses and outfits and toys and all this fun stuff. I can't create a doggone thing. I can't. I've learned to accept that a long time ago when my mom used to draw pictures and do poems, and my sister used to do the same thing, and I used to be like, why can't I draw? I can draw a stick figure, and it's not even the greatest. But God did not bless me in that. God did not give me that. So yesterday in church, I finally realized what God placed me here to be, what He put me on this planet in this time to do, and that was to inspire you. That was to inspire you in making the best out of your days, making the best out of what you have. Yes, I go to Dani Johnson events, but she amplifies in me what I already knew, what I've been hiding from. And it's not easy to come out of your shell. A lot of you, if you know me from a long time ago, you know that I'm shy, I'm closed up, I just don't do anything. I just stay in my little bubble, don't talk to me, don't touch me. That's me. And Dani Johnson brings out of me what God wants me to share with others. I'm a mother of two small children who are definitely not girly girls. So I don't get the dress up, I don't get the princesses, I don't get that fun stuff that I thought I was going to be doing. I get the tomboy, go, 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 accident prone, fearless, jumping off of stuff, finding ways to make mom go, and yes, I give that face often, and my husband tries to find several ways for it to happen. But I'm a mother of two small girls, and I'm a farmer's wife. I've been blessed to have this in my blood since I can remember. And when it's in your blood, you just can't get it out. So I'm a farmer's wife. We have several goats, several babies. No. We have three dogs, one of which is a stray, two of which actually are strays that my husband randomly brings home to me and says, here, can we keep it? And we have two kittens, five fish, five guineas, six chickens. I'm a busy woman. I also own my own home business that some days is not doing well at all, and that's my fault. Some days I just neglect it and I don't do anything. And that's what you sometimes do with the gifts that God gave you. You neglect it and you forget about it. You don't try to do anything with it. Here, baby. And you can't do that. Because when God gives you a gift, He wants you to go out and share it. Go out and do something with it. When you have a gift, and you know you have this gift, and you hide it away and say, it's mine, I'm not going to share it with anybody, or you say, oh, I'll put it away for another day, a rainy day, you know, hard times. I get that all the time. We're saving it for hard times. Do not hide this gift that God blessed you with. Don't hide it away. Show it to the world. Open up. Come out of that comfort zone that you have been comfortable in. We don't have chief, okay? You need to bless the world with what God blessed you with. So this is what my gift is. And I want you, if you know what your gift is, share it in the comments below. My gift is to inspire you. My gift is to get you up and find a different way. Don't have excuses. Yes, I'm all about no excuses now. But you have no idea. I'm the queen of excuses. I can come up with an excuse as to why not to exercise. I just want to sit here. I want to watch my shows on my computer, my TV. I want to snuggle with my kids and my dogs, and I just want to flat out be lazy. That's that. I'm a lazy person. Whatever. Think of me what you will, but it takes a lot some days to get off the couch and do my exercise. Get off the couch and do my business. But that's what our gift is. Our gift is a lot of work. And when you start to embrace that gift, God opens up so many other doors for you. I didn't know that I was blessed with the gift to inspire and guide people. It melts my heart when I get messages and comments on things saying that I've inspired them to do something. 90% of those people aren't even doing the programs that I do. So therefore, this mama doesn't get paid. But what I do get paid in is the sentimental side of things. I don't care about the money aspect. The fact that those people take time out of their life to see my posts and see that I have changed them, that is what I get paid in, whether I know it or not. When you comment to me and say, thank you for inspiring me to lose 57 pounds in the last 2 years, do you know how empowering that is? And that's God's way of telling me in the past of, hey, idiot, open up your eyes. This is what I've blessed you with. Will you take control over it now? And I've been in denial. Don't be in denial of what God has blessed you with. Embrace it. Make it you. Make it everything. You've heard the saying, if you love what you do, you'll never work a day in your life. I love inspiring people. It makes me cry. It melts my heart. It does everything.
Yeah.
It's just the same as when somebody comes up to you and says, thank you for this gift. You have no idea how much it's touched me. If I told you that, what would that make you feel? That would make you feel empowered and great and huge and everything else. So don't hide these gifts that God gave you. The only difference in me and you is I got started 2 years ago on my no excuses. But it also took me 27 years to figure out what my gift is. I'm 27 years old. I didn't get started until 2 years ago, 25. Come on, guys. Ask yourself this question. Where would I be if I had started 2 years ago with no excuses? It's not even about no excuses. Find a different way around it. Oh, I don't have the money to do this. We don't have the money to go out. We don't have the money to travel. Stop. Those are excuses. And it's holding you back from embracing your gift that God gave you. When you get past these excuses, you're going to be able to see all the bright things and wonderful things that God has for you in life. Instead of saying, I can't, or we don't have the money, start trying to find a way to get the money, or start trying to find a way to go to those places that you want to go to. If you want to travel, don't say, oh, I don't have the money for it. All you have to say is, we'll find a way. You know, we'll save up. $10 here, $5 here, you know, whatever. We'll find a way. It's no longer, I can't, or we don't have. Find a way. And God will bless you in more ways than you can imagine. It doesn't matter what your gift is. Because when you're happy, that's what shows your gift. And that's what God wants you to do. My gift right now is to help you to find your gift. Get up right now. Find that gift of yours and go out and do something with it. If your gift is to build up people, go build them up. Don't think about payment in the end. Think about, I'm doing this for God. I'm God's disciple. I'm going to do this. God has a plan for me. He's blessing me in this gift right here. I have a gift to draw. Draw pictures. You're going to inspire somebody to do the same thing. I hope that you had a great day today. It's mid-morning here, almost noon, in Virginia. I had a great time talking to you. I hope that you have a wonderful and blessed day. And think about it. This is a question that I'm going to leave you with again. Where would you be today if you had gotten started 2 years ago? I hope that you have a wonderful and blessed day. Bye.